with every single beat of my heart.
Welcome back to Queen the Greatest, our year-long journey through some of Queen's most memorable songs, performances, and achievements. In this episode, we continue our celebration of the extraordinary reception that has been enjoyed by Queen in Japan. The bond between the Japanese and Queen had been firmly established through the tours of the 1970s and 80s, but then Queen music continued to be treasured throughout the 90s and into the 21st century, thanks largely to their inclusion in TV commercials and dramas, particularly one of Japan's biggest drama series, which prompted the release of a special hits compilation album exclusive to Japan, Queen Jewels. The album went on to sell over a million copies. Having returned first with Paul Rodgers, Queen were invited back in 2014 with Adam Lambert to perform at the Summer Sonics Festival.
Summer Sonic is, you know, it's like Glastonbury or one of the biggest summer music festival outdoor shows. And we played Osaka and Tokyo, but I've seen many, many Summer Sonic festivals, but I think you should say everyone who I talked to, including staff bands and record company people, that was probably the biggest ending of act of any Summer Sonics in for 20 years or something.
Japan is once again a regular feature on the Queen touring schedule, indicating that this mutual love affair is still going strong.
The Japanese fan loved them. If the band didn't actually sort of return that kind of love, it wouldn't have got this big. And I think it's mutual respect of the culture, mutual respect of the people that's bonded by the greatest songs.
Konnichiwa! お元気ですか? Are you sure? This is especially for you. This was written for you guys in Japan a very long time ago. And if you want to sing, that would be wonderful.
Let's cling together.
Singing, we will.